morning. This is
again another broadcast of Chatting from the Chair with your host, Brother Oscar Yard. I am so delighted to bring this program to you every week. If I'm not sick or delayed, we usually film it on Monday morning. And we're so delighted that you are watching our program. At least we have around 22 subscribers that are watching us on a continuous basis. And again, I'd love to thank you for being a blessing to our show and watching it. But we want you to tell others about this show. If you are getting some kind of uplift from the show or inspiration, tell others about Chatting from the Chair with your host, Oscar Yard. I hope and pray that when you tell people about this show, they will also be uplifted and inspired, and others may come to Christ and be added to the body of Christ. We hope and pray that you do that. And for you all just viewing my show, we want you to be subscribers to our show. Also, if you are getting inspired from our show and find it a help in your Christian walk, I'd like to say this about some certain people that I've talked with from time to time, and I would like to mention Brother Eugene Lawton, Jr. and Sr. Just a couple of weeks ago, they lost a loved one. Brother Lawton Sr. lost his wife, and Brother Lawton Jr. lost his mother. We want to keep them in our prayers for their loss. And for others who have had lost in their families, I want to pray for you also. We want to hope that the Lord would comfort your hearts and minds at the time of your bereavement, because I recognize that when you lose someone, it's not easy. They will be missed very dearly. So the show here, Chatting from the Chair, love to pray for them that are going through some loss in their families. And I also want to pray for everyone that's watching this show that are going through some difficult times. Sometimes the world that we live in is not does not treat people right sometimes. So I want to pray for you all that are going through some difficulties in your life, and if this show here can help you to either face those difficulties or to soothe you of what you're going through, please allow us to do that. And again, we believe in prayer, right? We believe that when you pray to the Father, He's our Father, and He cares about us. So He will do what's best in our best interest to aid us through the things that we are facing or going through. So we want to pray at this time. Will you bow with me, please? Our Father, which art in heaven. Father, you are the great I am. Father, you are the kings and kings, lords of lords. Father, you are the bright and the morning star. Father, you're number one in our life. Father, we pray. Father, we thank you this morning for waking us up this morning and allowing us to see a day that never been promised to us before. But Father, because of your love and your mercy for us, you allow us to see another day. We pray for all those that are proclaiming the word, Father. We pray that you allow them to proclaim the word in such a way that others may come and to be a part and to be added to the body of Christ. And Father, we pray for this program. We pray that it reach out to those who need you, Father, in Jesus' name. Father, we pray for them to come to you and be added to the body. Father, we pray for those that are going through some difficult times. Father, we pray for those that are behind prison bars. Father, we pray for those that are in the nursing homes. We pray for those that are in the hospital facing a sickness that the doctors cannot do anything about. We pray, Father, that the doctors may aid them and help them in their sickness. Father, we pray for the lesson for today. Father, we pray that it has its merit to work on the hearts of men and women everywhere, that the word would not return to you void. In Jesus' name do we pray. Amen and amen. Like I said, I'm so thankful that you are joining us on today, and we hope and pray that you get something out of our show, and our lessons that we're trying to bring to you every Monday morning. And today we're still running our series on the Old Testament and the New Testament. The Old Testament and the New Testament. And on last Monday we mentioned about the shadow of things. And we are coming from Hebrews, the 8th chapter. And here the Hebrew, we were going to begin again at verse 5, because I want to mention some things that I left off last week. And I think we left off at the point of talking about this shadow. Well, the Hebrew writer says, who serve unto the example and shadow of heavenly things. Well, we must recognize that the law, the old law, was a shadow of a new law. The old law existed until the light came. And we even made the comparison when you're walking maybe in the moonlight and this cast a shadow, you see your shadow. And we even mentioned if you are in a brighter light, that shadow goes away. And we know that Jesus is the light. Jesus came into the world to die on the cross so that he can make it clearly, so he can fulfill the law of the old to bring in the new. And here, John, we want to read with John. I won't completely read it. I think last Monday I might have quoted it. But we want to read John first. John, turn with me to John. We want to show you that Jesus is that great light that came into the world to save you and I. And John says this. John said that, we'll get there. Here we are. John said, in the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. The same was in the beginning with God. All things were made by him, and without him was not anything made that was made. In him was life, and the life was the light of men. And the light shineth in darkness, and the darkness comprehend it not. That was a man sent from God whose name was John. The same came for a witness to bear witness of the light, that all men through him might believe. He was not that light, but was sent to bear witness of that light. That was the true light, which lighteth every man that cometh into the world. He was in the world, and the world was made by him, and the world knew him not. He came unto him his own received him not. But as many as received him, to them gave he power to become the sons of God, even to them that believe on his name, which were born not of the blood, not of the will of the flesh, not of the will of man, but of God. And the Word was made flesh, and dwelt among us, and we beheld his glory, the glory as of the only begotten of the Father, full of grace and truth. My friend, what we're saying here, that the old law, according to Hebrews 5, was a shadow of heaven things. And since Jesus came into the world, he became the light of the world. And we're no more under the shadow, because the light is here. The light is here. The New Testament and a new agreement is here. One thing that your house do not understand is, why do people still want to bring in the Old Testament? Most won't go back and grab what David did. But let me allow you to know this, that David lived under the Old Testament times. If you want to grab something that David did back then, you're still living. You want to bring the Old Testament in the New Testament, and you want to cut the New Testament out. We can't do that, my friend, because we're completely under the new agreement, the New Testament. We're under the new light, which is Jesus Christ. He's a higher light. He's a better light with better promises. Most of us, we want to bring in and grab what David said about music. I'm here to tell you this morning that when we read the New Testament, we read nothing about instrumental music. The only thing, from time to time, like I said, the only thing we can see is singing. So we won't go back and grab instruments. We got to grab what David said, and David lived under the Old Testament. Even much in the Old Testament, Amos 5:25, God even much himself said, get your vows away from me. So basically, if you are bringing an instrument of music, you're violating what the Word of God says. And many still wants to grab things that is contained in the Old Testament law. My friend, as I said, the Old Testament was a shadow of things to come. It was a shadow of things to come. And when the light comes, what the light does, it reveals things. What the light does, it shows you completely what things should be. In other words, it reveals, it illuminate what should be illuminate or revealed. And I believe this is what Paul tells us in Ephesians 3. Paul says in Ephesians 3:3-10, Paul says this. Paul said that, we get there in a minute. Paul says 3 and beginning with verse 3. Verse 3, Paul said, how that by revelation he made known unto me the mystery, as I wrote afore in few words, whereby when ye read, ye may understand my knowledge in the mystery of Christ, which in other ages was not made known unto the sons of men, as is now revealed unto his holy apostles and prophets by the Spirit. Now the Gentiles should be fellow heirs and of the same body, and partakers of his promise in Christ by the gospel, whereof I was made a minister according to the gift of the grace of God given unto me by the effectual working of his power unto me, who am least than the least of all saints. Is his grace given that I should preach among the Gentiles the unsearchable riches of Christ, and to make all men see what is the fellowship of the mystery which from the beginning of the world had been hid in God, who created all things by Jesus Christ, to the intent that not unto the principalities and powers in heavenly places might be made known by the church the manifold wisdom of God. See, the church, the message of the church in the Old Testament was hid, and today it is brought out by the light of Jesus Christ. His church, the church, was, as Paul said here, the church, the manifold, wisdom of God. See, it was God's wisdom to always bring man back in a saved place. It was always God's wisdom to connect man back to him after the first sin back in the Garden of Eden. It was God's intent to make us one in him. And God did it through Jesus Christ. God did it through his apostles. God did it through his prophets. Today, we're living in the New Testament, a better testament, a better light. For the light is here. If we want to go back and grab the Old Testament, what we are truly doing, we're saying that Jesus never came. If we're going back and grabbing something in the Old Testament, what we're saying is the light never came, but the light came and it brought in the new and living way. The new and living way. Don't you want to be part of that new and living way? Don't you want to be part of the church that you can read of on the pages of inspiration? Don't you want to be a part of the body of Christ that began on the day of Pentecost? At first, you do that by being rebirth again into the body. And as we just read, you're called by the gospel. First, you must hear the gospel. For Paul said in Romans 10:17, so then faith come by hearing, and hearing by the word of God. You must hear God's word. And I try to express that on the show here about the word of God. We talked about the New Testament and the Old Testament today. We told you how Jesus came and walked in the light to illuminate things most clearly. And the church was God's manifold wisdom. So do you want to be a part of that manifold wisdom, which is the church? You must hear the gospel. You must believe the gospel. For without faith, it is impossible to please him. For he that cometh to God must believe that he is, and that he is a rewarder of them that diligently seek him. You must believe. And then you must repent. Luke 13:3-5. I tell ye nay, except you repent, you shall all likewise perish. In other words, you must turn and change your mind about sin. And then you must confess Jesus. You must confess Jesus. Paul said in Romans 10:10, for with the heart man believe unto righteousness, but with the mouth confession is made, as we said many times, unto salvation. Not saved yet, unto salvation. And you only save until you complete the last stage, is baptism. You must be baptized. You must be baptized of the water and spirit and raise a newness of life. Romans 6. As Paul said, Romans 6, we are raised to live in new life. And then we must be faithful till the end. We must live a faithful life. See, God understands that we may fall by the wayside sometime. That's why Jesus Christ is a mediator. He's our mediator with God to help us along the way. But if you're not in his body, you're not covered by his blood, how can you help him? How can he help you? I know many may be getting upset with Brother York. I just mean it in love. I don't want to do any harm. So please, if you understand what I'm saying, please be added to the body of Christ. We're going to end it here. We want to talk about Osteo Publishing. Visit my webpage. Go to my store and order your book. Because I believe with reading there comes knowledge, and with knowledge there comes power. And as always, I got to pray. Let's pray. Our Father which art in heaven, Allah be thy name. Father, we thank you for this day. We thank you for this message about the Old Testament, New Testament. Help us with the series that we're talking about the Old Testament, New Testament. Help others understand that you want them to be in the body of Christ. Father, we pray for all that's listening. We pray for all that get understanding. In Jesus' name do we pray. Amen and amen. And as always, God loves you, and I do too. Goodbye. Have a wonderful day. Enjoy your day. May God bless you completely, wholly in him. Enjoy. Bye-bye. We'll see you next time.